Well, well, looky over my shoulder because I've got Bambu Labs' brand new H2D 3D printer. Hey guys, my name is Sam and welcome back to Samcraft. It is very, very, very late or early, however you read the clock. It is actually 4 a.m. March 25th, launch day, right now as I film this. Is Sam that late to the game? No. This printer arrived 7 p.m. on March 24th. I knew I wanted to get this video out to you guys, not because I was beholden or required to, but because this is exciting news. This is a machine that a lot of people in the 3D print community have been looking forward to, talking about, speculating about, and if I had it, I wanted to share it with you. So in today's video, it is going to be an unboxing, assembly, setup, and my first print ever, a flexi. Yeah, he printed a flexi. As I get going on this video with you guys, I wanna let you know that this is super, super short time frame for me. I just got this printer in this evening, filming all of this now, and I've got to edit it and upload it tonight as well. So there's gonna be a lot of stuff that I'm not able to show you, I'm not able to tell you, because I literally just got the machine. Many other people on YouTube will have had this machine longer than me. I just feel lucky that I had the benefit of getting it when I did, and I'm not complaining at all. Just letting you know why I may not say or know as much as others is because this baby's brand new to my shop. That being said, let's go ahead and jump into unboxing this very heavy, quite large 3D printer. All right, let's start with a good old-fashioned unboxing. This box, 97 pounds, is what your 3D printer is in. At least I assume it is. So Bambu was at least nice. They designed a box that you put on a table, then you can take it apart. You don't have to pull it out of the top. So let's throw this guy up on a table. Well, Bambu talked about making a bigger printer, and I think they did it. This is one big box. You know, it's a big box, it makes me look small. So thankfully they designed the box to be somewhat friendly. Although if you get to this point, you've already hefted 44 kilos or 97 pounds up on a table. Kudos. There are some little tabs at the bottom. Pull them out. And then what you're supposed to have is the most joyous unboxing you can buy. Is it awesome? Because I can't see jack squat. Let's use a little bit of electric lift here. Put this thing in a better view, because once we pull the cardboard sleeve off, you're gonna see it in all its plastic bag glory. You ready? Can't handle it, can you? If you're like me, you generally get excited, you dig into this thing, and when you get to the point when you open the inside, you see little red screws or stickers, you're like, hang on a second, there was a manual. So I'm gonna take a look at this quick start guide and make sure I do things proper, by the book, so to speak, and then get this unpacked so we can get this thing fired up and start to do something with it at least. According to the little quick start guide here, in order to take out the AMS-2 Pro unit out of the middle of this machine, I need to grab an Allen wrench out of the toolbox, remove the four Allen screws with little red stickers around them from the top bracket, two on the left, two on the right. Take the bracket out, take the AMS-2 Pro out, Then remove four more screws from the bottom bracket, again circled with the little red stickers, to get everything out and get this thing ready for use. With all of the blocks from the AMS out of there, plus the shipping screws holding the bed in place, now we've got three zip ties up here they want you to cut. This one can just slide right off the end of the drag chain and tubes, but the other two, those are some big old honkers. Those are at least 3/8 inch thick, so I'm gonna get some cutters for those. Once I remove those, then we take out this foam block. There's a couple of pieces of tape here. It's got little green tabs, you pull them off. And then otherwise, everything is done, with the last thing being the plastic on the door.
Send them back, or?
Everything is assembled, it is set up, connected. No filaments in the AMS just yet, but I just powered on the machine. As you can see, it's got some pretty good LED lighting inside. It's got this color bar on the bottom of the build plate, as well as LED lights left and right up top. What we're gonna do next though is set this guy up. Go ahead and connect it with the Bambu software so we can start using it. What I want to do next though is take it off of this roll around table because it's got a little wiggle wiggle to it. I want to put it over here on the table in the corner, power it up, connect it to my Wi-Fi, and then also go ahead and just start through the machine calibration. It's probably gonna take about 29 minutes at that point. All the initial calibrations are done, and this guy is telling me it's ready for filament. So I went over to my workshop and picked up an assortment of filament that I had. We'll go ahead and load it up here into the AMS. I've got four spools for the AMS, and then I'm gonna load one on the side onto the spool holder, because that spool holder, that side section, is what goes to one extruder, and all the AMS goes to another. So in order to test out the whole two extruder, we gotta load everybody up. All right, over here on the left side is where the spool holder is. And I'm gonna put this 1 kilogram roll of black PLA, and I'm gonna feed the filament up from the bottom into this tube guide. And push it in there until I feel it stop. As you go to load the filament, it's gonna pop up this message. And basically what it's saying is, as you're looking at the extruder, have you seen filament come out yet? Yes or no? If you've not, click on retry. It will move the extruder. It'll continue to push filament through. And basically you repeat this process until you see it come out the nozzle. So it's already got filament coming out. I told it to retry one last time so you can see it just barely on the left side. It is black filament, so it's hard to see. It's pulling a little bit through. But now, since we know it is good, what we'll say on this screen is done. And then now we're done. All right, guys, I want to pull this build plate off of here so I can clean it. But I thought it would be cool to also bring over a regular A1 or X1 size build plate, put it on top, let you guys see the difference there. A little bit of difference in build plate size. Now, something different about this machine, it does have waste on the left and right side, so you don't get the full build plate, but it is a big difference. That being said, let's spray it down with some 90% isopropyl alcohol, wipe it off with a microfiber cleaning cloth, and do our first test print. There's a USB port on top of the machine. That is for a flash drive to go in to be able to load files or also enable time lapse. So as I choose a model, I now have time lapse enabled. That was previously not an option without the flash drive being in there. I didn't get a flash drive with this machine. That's not to say you may not get one with yours, and there is not a micro SD card slot anywhere. So that's definitely something to note. This guy runs with flash drive. So we have our model, chose the Panda, right? We got white and black filament. We'll go ahead and tap on next. Here it is asking me if we want to use the left extruder, which we do, and it's showing that it's black PLA. For the right extruder, we're going to change from the dark blue to the white. Click on print, and there we go. Tells me an estimated hour and 16 minutes. One hour and 17 minutes later, our inverted panda, which actually honestly looks more like a cat, is finally done. And if you take a look, pretty successful print outcome. No messes, no problems, and looks pretty good, minus the colors being off. So one cool thing with this printer down here at the front, there is an LED bar that is attached to the build plate, and it acts as a print progress bar. So as the job was running, it would go from left to right and fill up. And it's kind of a bluish color. But now that the print job is done, it's green. So that's cool. Plus the machine makes a little jingle, which is nice. The X1 Carbon and the P1S don't really do that. The A1 machine does, but this one does now too. And then of course the screen here, this is similar to X1 Carbon type of feedback after you do a print job. So very cool. Well, let's go ahead and get this build plate out of here. All right, so we have our little guy here. Flex the plate. Came off really well. And yeah, first little flexible, honestly, the first flexi I've ever printed, guys. So here you go. I'm in the flexi business now. I'm just kidding. There you go. Interesting. Neat. As far as color bleed through and everything, doesn't exist because obviously separate nozzles, and print quality was great. Layer lines on this one are fine, you know, maybe not the cleanest at the very top there, but for a default print profile out of the machine and for the first one out of this machine entirely, pretty cool. So my first thoughts after the first print out of the machine, it works perfect. Awesome, right? Yeah, that's what we want to see. Now, is this a complete test? Did I really put it through the paces? I don't really think so. I mean, there were a lot of nozzle swaps in this 127 layer print that we did, but I mean, it's kind of small. It wasn't a multi hour print. So just take it for what it's worth. Again, this video is just unboxing, setup, and testing it with one print. And again, as of like right now, it's close to 4 a.m. and the day of this video being published. So I guess I'll be pulling an all-nighter to get this edited and published in time. Not that Bambu is putting me under any kind of time constraints. I just know that when this launches and everyone's out there consuming it, it would be nice for me to have my video out there as well. So, doing this to myself. That being said, hopefully you did enjoy getting to see the Bambu H2D printer. This is the standard printer, so it doesn't include all the other accessories that does exist or will exist very soon with this model, but hopefully I can get my hands on those when they come available and show it to you guys as well. Likewise, even though this is just the first video, if there are things specifically you want to see about this setup, so the printer, the two nozzles, everything, let me know in the comments down below. I've got a handful of ideas already as far as content that I want to make for it. Obviously, I want to do something that shows off the build size or the build volume, compare it to my X1 Carbon, my P1S, my A1 printers, so you get a visual representation of just how large you can print with this versus the other machines. Of course, I also want to do some more tests with multiple filaments, probably work in some TPU, all of which I need to purchase because I don't have anything in my shop but PLA or PETG. So that'll take a little bit of time to get in. But like I said, if you've got ideas, definitely leave me a comment down below. Hopefully you did enjoy the video, right? It was a pretty exciting thing. It's a new machine. And while unboxing videos really I don't like to do, I thought this one was an okay deviation in that because it is so new and it's pretty rare that I get something like this really new out of the gate. That's it for this one, guys. Take care as always, and I'll see you next time in the workshop.